To the Bikini Hour. We have Finn, Lisa, and Joanne. We're not quite finished, but we're almost finished for the morning.
There is something very nice and very mellow coming up, the Reggae Explorer. It will make you feel very good. We are located on the Estella College campus in East Orange, New Jersey. And we are WFM News 91.1. Listener-supported radio. Please support us if you like us. Merry Christmas. I'd like to say hello to my cat, Peabody, and the monster. And thanks for all the nice phone calls I got.
If it weren't raining, I could see the Eiffel Tower from here. This is my room in the Chateau de l'Hermitage in Montmorency, France. It's May 11th, 2010, and they really are, you know, they're letting me out of protective custody after only 8 days because I'm really not sick. A little bit of fine-tuning might be needed on the psychiatric and physical level, but there's really nothing wrong with me. I'm just tired and traumatized, and I've been a victim. But I have an amor fati. You know, the philosopher Nietzsche said that you have to have an amor fati. I studied Nietzsche when I was 18, and I was first in college. I took an existential philosophy course at Kent State, and Nietzsche said you must have an amor fati, you know. You must love what's happening to you, even if it sucks. You know, grab it and love it, because that's life. You know, if you want to play the victim, or you know, be angry or rancorous or sneaky with your life, and have a lot of regrets about things, well, that's your business. But I don't advise you to stick with that. You know, Nietzsche was the guy who wrote "God is dead," which isn't quite what he said, but I think he was rather misquoted. But anyway, you know. Amor fati, a love of fate, and amour de destin. You know, it's what's happening, baby. Love it. Work with it. See you later.